figures of speech are what we really need to make our poetry dance and our writing sing. We'll use similes with the words as or like to compare two things that might not be alike. Then we'll take away the as or like to say the test was an uphill mountain hike, which is a metaphor, and you can all see that figurative language is the key. Another element that might be fun is a silly little thing called a pun. It relies on two words that are kind of the same to make your poem into a joke or a clever game. Synecdoche and metonymy have similar meanings. You can see they both use simple words to describe something whole, which makes your poetry not so dull. There's also a thing called personification that gives non-human things human-like qualifications. Use apostrophes to talk to something that can't hear you, like a star, a knife, or a couch that is blue. Paradox and oxymoron put words together that may seem sorta odd, but look at them closely and you'll find out it's the truest thing you've ever heard about. Figures of speech are what we really need to make our poetry dance and our writing sing.